Well, traditionally, glaucoma surgery has used to be reserved for patients who show signs of progression despite maximal medical treatment, or who present uncontrolled IOPs despite maximal medical treatment. Other indications for glaucoma surgery would be patients who are not adherent with their glaucoma medication, or who are not tolerant to glaucoma medications. Now, with the advent of mixed procedures in glaucoma surgery, we can also propose glaucoma surgery specifically with mixed to patients for quality of life reasons, simply because they omit to put their glaucoma drops, or if because it poses quality of life issues for them. Well, the benefits of mixed surgery from the patient's point of view are, first of all, that mixed procedures generally are safer than trabeculectomy or traditional glaucoma surgery. Mixed procedures take longer, the surgery time is shorter, which is an advantage for the patient who needs to spend less time under the microscope. And visual recovery is generally faster, substantially faster sometimes than after trabeculectomy, so patients' quality of life is improved. From the surgeon's point of view, advantages are again safety issues, which are better with mix. The surgeon can do more surgeries in the same amount of time with mix than with traditional glaucoma surgeries. On the negative side, or limitations of mix, are first of all the additional cost compared to glaucoma surgery, traditional glaucoma surgery. Second, I would say that there is a paucity of data for most of mixed surgical procedures. There's specifically a paucity of randomized controlled trials. We do not know yet how well mixed procedures fare after 3, 4, or 5 years. That's a good question. I'm not sure mix have replaced trabeculectomy as the reference standard in glaucoma surgery. I don't think this is the case so far. In my own clinical practice, since I started to introduce mix as an alternative, I am probably doing about 50% fewer filtering surgeries, deep sclerectomy or trabeculectomy. However, now after 3 or 4 years, I see that some of my mixed patients have to be converted into traditional glaucoma filtering surgery. What we don't know yet is how well mix perform in a head-to-head comparison with trabeculectomy. The first RCT doing such a comparison has just been presented. It's an RCT that compared the preserved flow microshunt compared to trabeculectomy. We hope to have many more such RCTs where there is a head-to-head comparison between trabeculectomy as a reference standard and mixed procedures. I think what has happened so far through mix, rather than to reduce the number of trabeculectomies, is that the surgical scope has become larger. There are probably more patients now who we operate with mix, or who undergo some kind of glaucoma surgery, who did so before the introduction of mix. It's hard to name a single one. There are many different mix techniques or stents that are exciting. Some follow the traditional route, subconjunctival route, either up internal or up external. Others go through the Schlemm's canal, trying to enlarge Schlemm's canal to bypass trabecular meshwork. And here, interesting questions, anatomic, scientific questions come up. For example, once you go through the Schlemm's canal, you open it up, what happens to collector channels? Does it matter the state of collector channels vis-a-vis the placement of stents? And exciting as well is the fact that now through different techniques, we can go into the suprachoroidal space and try to have that route activated in addition to the traditional routes. In our course, different aspects of mix were presented and discussed. Results were presented. If I had to name a few different aspects and take-home messages, is that we now have increasing evidence that mix are here to stay as an alternative to glaucoma surgery. We know, however, that the quality of data is still not optimal. We hope to have more randomized controlled trials, also head-to-head comparison of mixed devices to each other. In the World Glaucoma Association consensus book on glaucoma surgery, which will be presented at the American Academy of Ophthalmology in a few weeks from now, we have identified several aspects of mix that need to be addressed. The first of them would be getting more RCTs to compare them to each other. The second one would be the need to have data from non-Caucasian populations. Almost all studies that are out there have looked at mix in Caucasians. We need to know how good they fare in Asian populations, in patients of African ancestry. And thirdly, I would say cost issues have to be addressed. We need to see whether the cost of mix justify the use of mix in terms of efficacy and safety as well.